Let's take a look at custom forms. The forms in NetSuite provide a simple way to collect and store information in an organized format, but sometimes the standard forms don't adequately meet your company's needs. In situations like that, you will want to create custom forms. There are three main types of forms you can customize. First, there are entry forms. Entry forms are used to collect information and store it in NetSuite. Some of the record types that use entry forms to collect information include employee, vendor, and customer records. Second, there are transaction forms. Transaction forms are used to add transactions like sales orders, purchase orders, and work orders to NetSuite. They are also used to print transactions. Third, there are address forms. Technically, there is only one standard address form, but it has enough unique characteristics to warrant a separate tab from entry forms and transaction forms. You have two main options for creating custom forms. First, you can navigate to Customization, Forms, and choose the type of form you want to create. Under the Edit column of that page, you'll have the option to click Edit or Customize. If a form has the Customize option, that means it is a standard form. Forms that have the Edit option, on the other hand, have already been customized. Choose the standard form you want to change and click Customize. Alternatively, you could create a custom form by editing a record or transaction that uses the form. Simply navigate to the record or transaction whose form you want to customize, click Edit, and under the Customize tab in the upper right corner, select Customize Form. When you customize a form, you will want to give the form a unique name. Otherwise, NetSuite will automatically apply custom to the beginning of the original name of the standard form. You will also have the option of providing a script ID for the form. You can change the appearance of either entry or transaction forms in similar ways. According to SuiteAnswers, on the custom form, you can rearrange, rename, hide, or disable fields, subtabs, and buttons. You can also make specific fields mandatory, add custom fields, or apply custom code. To make these types of changes, use the subtabs on the custom form page. When you initially create either a custom entry or transaction form, there are some checkbox options in the first field group that direct how that form will be used. The first of these is inactive. If you mark a form as inactive, then you would only see it on the custom forms page, provided you have also checked the show inactives box on that page. A second checkbox is store form with record. According to the NetSuite field help, this checkbox ensures that your records are viewed and edited with this form regardless of who is viewing or editing the record. Form is preferred is the third checkbox that entry and transaction forms have in common. This checkbox simply indicates that you wish for this custom form to be preferred over the standard NetSuite form. In other words, when a user creates a new record or transaction, this form would be the one NetSuite defaults to. Note that you can mark only one form as preferred for any given record or transaction type. In the event that you want to have different preferred forms for different roles, you can specify that on the Manage Roles page. For more in-depth study of custom forms, we would recommend that you check out the SuiteAnswers page on custom forms. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at SuiteRep.com.